And good morning to you, boys and girls. It's Saturday, the 8th of April 2017. I've got to say, I'm already a little bit disappointed with myself this morning, boys and girls, because I'm looking over there at my calendar. You can see it here. Yeah, I'm looking over there at my Barry Manilow calendar, okay? And where it says the 8th of April, it says 12 stone target. And I didn't get there. How disappointed. I've given up. We're only a week left of Lent now, boys and girls. Tomorrow is Palm Sunday. There's only a week left of Lent. That's a week left of not having bread, crisps, cakes or sweets. But the weight hasn't shifted. What is going on, dear? I must be at my optimum weight. That is the answer. I am at my optimum weight. Well, good morning to you, gang. Welcome along this morning. I have to say, I've already been extremely busy today. Oh, yes, I got up. I dealt with a cat, dear. Give her some food. Had me breakfast. Had me pills. And I've cut the grass front and back. Oh, there's no stopping here. So I'm just waiting for my mate now. He's going to ring me later on. We've got to go into town and get his new set of glasses out. And also, I thought while I was in town, I might pop into Waitrose because they do this dry cleaning thing. And here's that jacket I was talking to you about yesterday that, you know, it just needs to be, I don't know, steamed or something. I think it was Kelly Kim yesterday who said I needed to steam the jacket. Can you see how that, this is the worst bit, okay? The buttons won't stay out on the, I don't know what that's called. That's not a lapel, is it? You know the bit that you do up? The button. Ooh, what was that? Oh, just a minute. Let me turn that off. Turn that off. Yeah, they kind of fold over. Can you see what's happened to it? And I can't work it out. So there we are. I might take that into Waitrose a little bit later on. Yesterday, after I finished chatting to you yesterday, I popped outside into the hall and there's a wasp in my house. Great big fat thing it was. Reminding me of a few people I've seen in the last few weeks in the shopping centre, dear. Dear me, great big fat wasp there was buzzing away in my bathroom. And anyway, I very quickly flicked open the bathroom window and out it flew. But I wonder how it got there. Because I don't open the windows generally, except for the ones that I've got this like white gauze stuff that I stuck up. It was only supposed to be temporary. And actually, it needs to be replaced now. I put it up last summer so that you can throw the doors open. Like being in Spain. Or Italy, somewhere like that. You know where you can throw the doors open and you've got this gauze there and the evil insects can't get in. Well, where's this wasp come from then? I can't remember leaving a window open or something like that. It must have been living here all winter, hiding in the crevice, in the top of a curtain thing or something like that. Very, very scary. Great big fat thing it was. So I dealt with the wasp. And then I thought, don't laugh at this, please. Don't laugh at this. I thought I'd better deal with this. Now, this is a letter I've had from PensionWise. PensionWise, boys and girls. Have you had your free appointment with PensionWise? Because next year, I'll be 55. And I start getting a private pension if I want to take it. It's very, very small. We're talking 50 quid a week. That's all we're talking, 50 quid a week. But 50 quid's 50 quid, and you can do some other things with it. So I've had a few bits and pieces. Look, it's time to choose your pension, and all this booklet's coming through the post now. I can't believe it. I can't believe I'm getting all this stuff through the post. So you get a free appointment, something to do with the government. So I've booked my appointment for Wednesday the 26th. So I'm going to an appointment with PensionWise. You have to take your details of your private pension with you. And also they wanted to know your government state pension. Now, let me just refer to my notes that I took earlier on. Now, the government state pension is the thing that everyone gets. And from that will be from 2030. So quite a way to go there, to go yet. But it's a good idea to check where you are with this, because this relates to how much national insurance contributions you've been paying in. And if you've missed some, or you've missed years, then you won't get the full amount. Now, according to this, I will be getting the full amount in 2030 of £155.65 per week. How fantastic is that? I suppose it'll probably be more by then, won't it? Because it goes up every year, doesn't it? Doesn't it go up? I don't know what it is now. But it says, this is not a guarantee, but is based on current law and does not include increases due to inflation. Now, at the moment, you need to continue to... Forecast... Okay, so I need to contribute for another 6 years to get up to the maximum. And that's the maximum you can get. So it looks like I'm on track for doing that. Now, you can check your own one if you want. You know, and if you're... I think... I don't know if you have to be a certain age to be able to check it. Might be worth you having a look there. But if you go on... Right, here's the website. Have you got a pen, Andy? Come on, dear. Chop, chop with your pen. You can do this while I'm chatting away, can't you? You can do this. Right? It's gov.uk/check-state-pension. Have you written that down? No. Why do I bother? I bother because I care, boys and girls. I care. And you always hear the pop stars. We really care for our fans. Yeah, as long as you keep buying the records, dear. All right, gov.uk/check-state-pension. And there, you have to put in details and set things up and things like that. But it's worth doing because you want to know you're getting the maximum money. And if you don't think, if it tells you you're not going to get the maximum money, you will still have time to do something about it. You can catch up, so to speak. Anyway, I spoke to this woman on the phone yesterday, this woman at State Pension, because I rang them as well. I had a bit of trouble doing it on the internet, admittedly, but there's a phone number as well, so you can ring them. And I said, I'm not being too early with this, am I? You know, because it's like 2030. Do you know what I mean? She said, no, not at all. She said, you wouldn't believe the amount of people that ring us a week before they're due to retire. And then, if they haven't caught up at that point, nothing they can do. Too late. You must be prepared, as R. Kayla said in the Cub Scouts. Be prepared. I promise that I will do my duty to the Scouts. And, oh, I can't remember the Scout promise. Anyone remember that one? Who remembers the Scout promise? That's the question. So there we are, sorting out my private pension for next year. Of course, I don't have to take it next year. I think you can delay it. Or you can take part of it. Maybe if you're with me as a partner, you know, I might use the money to take you on holiday. The phone will start ringing now. Gold diggers, dear. That's what they are, gold diggers. I sniff them a mile off. Gold diggers, you can smell them a mile off. All right, hello, Chris. Are you going to buy me a drink? Gold digger. No, thank you very much. No, gold digger. I can smell a gold digger watching a show. Is it you? Is it you? So that was the pension thing I did last night. What else? Great night last night at the karaoke. Lots of lovely new faces in there last night. It really was. And we were celebrating Alex, the bus driver's birthday yesterday. So he came and sung a couple of songs. Alex Burrows, who we're singing happy birthday to at the end of today's show, along with, of course, all the other birthdays as usual. Right? Very pleased to tell you my TomTom is now working. Now, the new TomTom, remember I told you a couple of days ago, the new TomTom, that this is an app for the iPhone. So the old one, they're going to be retiring. Now, the traffic thing on it hasn't been working. So she gave me a free link to the new TomTom and 3 updates for 3 years. I mean, that's not bad, is it? But yesterday that stopped working. So I rung them up. Once again, they answered within 10 seconds of me starting ringing. I told her the problem. And she was on the phone with me, this woman. I think she was in India or Pakistan, one of those two. Very polite. Aren't they polite? Don't you find that? When you ring these people and it's diverted to call centres in India or Pakistan are particularly polite and lovely people. But it's their names that always make me laugh. You know, they're speaking in like Pakistan. Hello, my name's John. Huh? Oh, hello, my name's Mark. Hello, in an accent. Hello, my name's Mark. How may I help you? Like that. And Mark, why don't you just tell us your real name? I don't believe your name is Mark. What's all that about? I mean, I could be sitting here saying that I'm Barry Manilow. You wouldn't believe me, would you? No. Why don't they just use their real names? And her name, I'll wait for this. What do you think her name was yesterday? Twinkle. Honestly, hello, my name's Twinkle. How might I help you? Did she know I was gay? Is that what it is? She was trying to impress me with a word like that by using the word twinkle. My name's Twinkle. Anyway, she answered within 10 seconds. And she was on the phone with me for about 20 minutes. And what we had to do was completely delete the app. Do you know I need to blow my nose? Do you mind a moment? Excuse me. Oh, dear. We had to delete the app and then re-download the map and all that business and put in the password, put in the email address, and everything suddenly worked. So that was sorted, and I used that on the way into work last night, and it all seemed to be working quite well last night. Not too much traffic on the road. Alex P, as I say, it was his birthday yesterday, and Gustav, who informs me that I do wear High Street very well. So thank you very much for that, Gustav. He's also impressed by this shirt, which he says must be a favourite of mine, as it's faded so much. Any rude? Gustav. Anyway, kind Gustav as he is, he bought in an entire box of cupcakes with happy birthday written on them for Alex yesterday. Isn't that a nice thing to do? It really is. If you've never been to Central Station, I do the karaoke there on Mondays, 8 till 11.30 and Fridays, 8.30 to 12. It is so friendly in there. People have birthdays and random people just bring in gifts. I think it was Maureen's birthday a couple of weeks ago, and Kin, who is an excellent singer, young Kin, he bought her in an orchid or something. I can't remember what it was now. It might have been, was it a bar of chocolate? Can't remember, but doesn't matter. Kin just bought in a gift for Maureen. Isn't that a nice thing to do? Really is. So, it's so friendly. If you ever want to come down there, Central Station, Mondays 8 o'clock, Fridays 8.30, that's in Wharfdale Road in King's Cross, okay? So that was the night. On the way home, sadly, I stopped and I had chips and a vanilla milkshake at the little Asian chicken shop just before Kew Bridge, which is closed at the moment. You can't go over Kew Bridge. Oh, yes, you can. Did I go over Kew Bridge? No, I think it was closed. And then, lo and behold, the M3 was open last night. Well, I nearly had to pull over and have a rest. I couldn't believe it. The M3 was actually open last night. Junctions 2 to 3, because they keep closing it. So I was able to go along there. And I haven't been along that road for months. M3 is generally the way I used to go home all the time. I have to go generally M4 all the way. Or M4, M25, A30 home. Because I live in Bracknell in Berkshire. I quite like the A30. It's a nice, relaxed road. Except when you've got a great big lorry behind you flashing its lights. Will I go any faster? No, I will not, dear. We must stick to the speed limits. No points, thank you very much, on my licence. Got in. Unfortunately, Katie had made another mess on the floor. Oh, but fortunately, I've got my puppy pads. My puppy pads are all on the floor. So what she's gone is done number twos and walked round and round and round and round and round and round. Oh, I mean, when you open the kitchen door, the smell hits you. It is ghastly. Absolutely ghastly. But, you know, it's one of those things. So I cleaned up after her, you know, folded up the puppy pads, put them in the bin, put some more puppy pads down, and I went to come up to clean my teeth and went straight to bed. And that was it, really. That was my day. That was my afternoon yesterday. So good. As I say, this morning I've cut grass. I was very, very disappointed with someone actually who I don't know that well. I don't know everyone on Facebook, perhaps, as well as I know you, if you see what I mean. You know, a lot of people add because they like the show or they come to karaoke nights and things like that. But there was a comment on there this morning from someone. Happy Dead Thatcher's Day. Margaret Thatcher was one of the prime ministers in this country. Some would say one of the best prime minister this country's ever had. But someone, some people liked her, some people disliked her. Right, but to put a comment on there, such as Happy Dead Thatcher Day. I think is just awful. Awful. So I said nothing. I just unfriended her. It's very, very rare for me to unfriend someone. I just think that is a nasty, nasty thing to say. How can you celebrate someone's death like that? Happy Thatcher's Dead Day. Nasty. So they've gone. They've gone. And, you know, whatever you think. You know, I'm not a fan of Jeremy Corbyn. But if it, I mean, would you remember when Mrs. Thatcher died? They were having parties. You know, celebrating the death of Margaret Thatcher. It's dreadful. Ghastly people. Ghastly. You know, if Jeremy Corbyn was to die tomorrow, I'm not a fan of his. I wouldn't throw a party. You know, I would be respectful. Respectful. He does what he believes in, doesn't he? You know, he absolutely does what he believes in. Not the same politics as me. But I wouldn't go around dancing and thought, oh, great, Jeremy Corbyn is dead. That's just horrible and nasty. And I can't believe someone put that on Facebook. Anyway, they've gone. Good riddance to them, dear. Good riddance to them. Good. It's a beautiful day out there again. Absolutely stunning day. The sun's out. I've cut the grass. Things are growing. Although it's very, very dry, as I said yesterday. I've got to give it a good water today. Let's say hello to some people this morning who are joining us. Hello to Rod Brown. Adam the Plumber's with us, who's setting up a new website. Adam the Plumber. It's all new to him. He's got a domain. And he's designing his own website with one of those free applications, which are very good. I mean, I don't really have a website anymore. I have my stuff pointing to my Facebook pages now, because everything's on there. Everything I do is on Facebook. So it just points there. But Adam's actually going to set up a website. I did have a website once, and I used Wix, W-I-X.com. Very, very easy to use, even for me. Even for me, very easy to use, Wix.com. So if you ever want to have a look at that, then you want to set up a website or something like that, then do it, all right? Some more people this morning. Good morning to Alan Gamble, who's with us today. Good morning, Alan. How are you? I never see you on here. What are you doing on here? You've got nothing to do, dear. There must be something for you to do in your sad, lonely, pathetic life, dear. Eh? Sorry, Alan, I love you. You know that. Hello, Alan Gamble. Colin's with us this morning. Morning, Colin. Elaine's there. Hello, Elaine. Stephen's there. Good morning, Stephen. Kelly Kim says, morning. I tell you, your shows are really keeping me going during the holidays, dear. Well, it's me or Jeremy Kyle. Take your pick. Take your pick, Kelly Kim. There's not going to come anyone through that door going, you slept with my daughter. You slept with my daughter. And all that. There's none of that going on here, dear. It's clean family fun. That's what it is here, Kelly Kim. Clean family fun. And she says, Kelly Kim, much better than watching Jeremy Kyle. Thank you, Kelly Kim. Thank you. Elaine says, do you have screens on your windows? No, I know what you mean. No, I don't. I would like them, but I don't know where to get them. On Amazon, what I've got is this Velcro stuff, right, that you put around the window. And then it's just a gauze that you kind of tighten up. But it's very temporary. And eventually it just starts pulling away at the Velcro. So it doesn't work that well, I don't think. But yes, I would like some sort of screen. So perhaps something magnetic, maybe, where you could just put it up there and then take it down again. I can't stand insects in the house, especially wasps. Oh, I hate wasps. Evil gits. Evil, evil bastards, wasps. They really are. Let's say, Elaine's there. Good morning to Johnny Key this morning. Ross Baker. Hello, Ross Baker Hill. Hello, Ross. Good morning to Ross. Wayne Martin says, I missed the start of the show. Well, if you can't get up on time, Wayne, you know, if you can't get up on time, then so be it. Maybe I'll be late. If you ever book me in for one of your discos, I might just be late to do that. Next time you book me in to do one of your karaoke's, I might just turn up late, you know, same as you do to my show. Rude. That's what it is. Rude, dear. Rude. Elaine says, you can spend money on me when you come back to Israel. I'm very much looking forward to coming back to Israel at some point. I think next year. I think it's going to be next year, Elaine. All right, darling. Morning to John Child, who's moved to South London. God, that was brave of you. Whereabouts in South London are you? Do let us know. And I'll tell you, on a scale of 1 to 10, how safe you are. We might go into negative equity there with that one. Good morning to Pete Branch. Morning, Pete. Elaine. Let's stop that, Ross. Ross, stop that now. Stop that now. Let me see. Where is that nice? Wayne says, Wayne will be covering me at Central Station. Are you getting an advert in for yourself there, are you, Wayne? Wayne will be covering one of my nights at Central Station on... One moment, please. Easter Monday. Easter Monday the 17th, OK? Wayne will be doing my night at Central Station. Now, if there's any karaoke people watching today, I have to tell you, Wayne is a competent karaoke host who does his own shows in Reading, in Maidenhead. I think there's another one as well. He does regular places and he doesn't get sacked from places. Rarely get... I don't know if you've ever been sacked here, but he doesn't get sacked from places, so he ain't bad. Obviously not as good as me, but he's not bad, dear. And he does require a constant supply of sandwiches, I've heard. Is that right, Wayne? Every half hour, he must be given a plate of sandwiches. Otherwise, he just passes out. All right, so Wayne will be covering that for me on Easter Monday, the 17th of April, OK? Elaine says, just curious, why don't you put Barry's picture disc under the Mandy record instead of behind your chair? Ah. Yes, the picture disc is covering a seam in the backdrop. That's why that's there, OK? And you do see him. He kind of appears now and again, doesn't he? He just appears now and again. Now and again, Barry appears. But we can't have him too prominent because it might take the spotlight away from me, Livy. That's a joke. Right, Elaine. Oh, dear. Alan is doing housework today. Oh, rather you than me, Alan. I hate that, don't you? Although, you know that dust I've been going on about weeks and weeks on the shelves in front of me? You can't see that. Just a minute. Where are we now? On the shelves in front of me here. I've been telling you there was loads of dust there, yeah? Well, it's all gone. It's all gone. I went to Waitrose yesterday, boys and girls, and I purchased the... wet wipe type things, and I've used a couple of those, and oh, hang on, there's a bit there, and all the dust has gone from this shelf. Now I've just got to do the rest of the room. Dear me, look at it all. There's a load of stuff in here that could be chucked away. A hell of a load of stuff. There's stuff up there. I've got stuff up there which has not moved for about 5 years. And it's mad. There's probably, you see, the things like newspaper cuttings and things like that. And, you know, I just think you have to let go of it all at some point. I really do. You just can't keep collecting stuff and stuff and stuff all the time. And now and again, I do go through drawers and things like that. Do you? I'm sure you've got one of those things in the kitchen, a drawer of many things, have you? I bet you have. You've got a screwdriver in there, a few nails, a bit of sellotape, that sort of thing. Soldering iron. I've got one of those downstairs. And you can't find anything in there because it's all jumbled up. It's all over the place. Have you got a drawer of many things at home? Very interesting. Shall we open the phone line? There's the phone line. If you want to call in this morning, phone lines are now open, boys and girls. Bing! There it is. Phone line's up there. If you want to call in at any point this morning about something, it's 020-8144-3477. My local London number. Not premium rate. 020-8144-3477. You don't have to call in. Okay, I don't base the show on phone calls. Often no one calls in, which is okay. It doesn't matter. But if you want to, the phone number's there. Anything about what I'm talking about, anything about that we are talking about this morning, including perhaps you've got a drawer of many things, have you? Have you got a drawer of many things? What's in it? I want to know what's in your drawer of many things. Let me know. 020-8144-3477. There's also a Skype. If you've got Skype and you're somewhere else in the world, you want to save the old money, save your new Israeli shekels, for example, if you're in Israel, save your American dollars, save your Slovakian crowns, then you can use Skype. My Skype username is United Kingdom Talk. Skype username United Kingdom Talk. Phone number 020-8144-3477. That's all the bits and pieces there, boys and girls. Gustav, unfortunately, has a bit of a headache today. He was rather drunk last night, Gustav. It was such a nice thing of you to bring those cakes, and it really was. You're a true friend to Alex. I hope he knows that. Yes, of course he does. John, oh my God, John Child had moved to South London to Deptford. Oh my God, that really is, it's worse than Croydon. That is worse than Croydon. Have you been to Deptford? Listen, it's not a case of locking your doors as you drive through. It's a case of completely avoiding that area. Never, ever go through Deptford. What an absolute dump. What on earth possessed you to move there, John? My God, you must be terrified in your bed at night that someone's going to come crashing through your window. I bet you've got metal bars up at the windows and all that, haven't you? Oh, but it'd be like living in the Bronx, dear. In fact, the Bronx is probably safer than that. Deptford? Peckham's better than that. Deptford? What on earth possessed you to move there? Oh, it's nearer to my job. Is it nearer to your job or something? I can't think of any reason in the world you would want to move to Deptford. Ghastly place. No wonder you won't come to the karaoke. I'm just thinking of you, you know, trying to get back home at 12 o'clock at night, walking through the streets of Deptford, where it is evil. Evil place, Deptford. Is that Southwark Council? Oh, God. You frighten me now, John. I shall permanently worry about your life now that you've told me you live in Deptford. Good morning to Jerry, who's with us this morning. Wayne, oh, come on, Wayne, do us a favour. He says no sandwiches. Come on, Wayne. I have been told by the lovely Marie and various other people that you need a constant supply of sandwiches streaming their way to your little DJ podium. I know that, thank you. Elaine says, I've got a drawer next to my bed, and believe me, you don't want to know what's in it. Oh, my God, does it plug in? Does it plug in, Elaine? Oh, dear. Adam the Plumber's on the line. Good morning, Adam.
Good morning, Chris Reardon. How are you?
Chris Reardon, international celebrity. A good morning to you. How are you? All right?
I'm not too bad, thank you.
What's new, darling? Have you got a draw? Yep.
Sorry, go on.
You go.
What? Yep. Okay. Phoning in a couple of things this morning. First one about my drawers.
Have you got any on this morning?
I have.
How unusual. Yes, go on then.
Yes, drawers of many things. I've got many things in drawers, actually.
Oh, yeah.
I have a junk drawer under the microwave. It's full of plug tops and screws and fuses and old cat toys. I don't know why they're in there.
Cat toys? What, little balls and things like that?
Yeah, little balls.
Have you got one of those bouncing balls that you bang on the ground and they go like 200 foot up in the air? I like those.
No, I haven't got one of those. I've got one, a mouse that you throw on the floor, and when it hits the floor, it goes chip, 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 chip. Or a little birdie. I think it is a bird, actually.
A mouse lived in a windmill in old Amsterdam. Yes.
Yeah, that's the one. I've got a drawer of many, many, many bits of junk that I keep threatening to go through one day, but just keep on adding to.
Do you never go through it?
I have a habit of adding to it instead of subtracting from it.
Do you never go through your drawer?
Occasionally I go through my drawers and find interesting and strange and mysterious things.
Strange and mysterious. Yes.
Yeah, so strange and mysterious things in my drawers. You know, things that I haven't seen for years in my drawers. When I look down there, you know, at them. But, you know, I do. I keep meaning to clean it out, but for some reason, I seem to add to it.
I know, yeah. And then you go to open it. Is it right that sometimes you go to open it and it won't open because something you've put in there has stuck up? Yes,
that's right. Yeah,
and you can't so get the damn drawer
get the
open again.
Out and start poking it around, and then you think, right, I'll go through the drawer, and you sort of move a few things out of the way, and you think, okay, the drawer closes now, and then you just close it again.
We've got all sorts of things in those kitchen drawers. Yeah, I was down the garden centre this week.
Yep.
With my garden vouchers that Auntie Brenda bought me. At Christmas. So I've got three hanging I bought three hanging baskets. They were only £5 each. All planted up. I thought that was good value. So I've got to the till with these things. Don't take those vouchers. Oh, no, I couldn't believe it. Couldn't believe it. So I had to pay cash, dear. Anyway, while I was in the garden centre, we're talking about kitchens here. They had a lot of these gardens. It's a massive garden centre, Long Acres Garden Centre in Bracknell. And they've got all sorts of things in there, food and all this. And they have, like, kitchens. And walked past, I never really look at it. Don't take any notice. As I was suddenly, it stuck out like a sore thumb at me. This stunning, stunning red granite top. Lovely. Oh my God, Adam! It was beautiful. It's like the colour of like pillar box red with little sparkly bits in it. I suppose that's the granite, is it? The sparkly.
Yeah,
bits?
That would be the granite. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's kind of got a lip. And I just stopped and stood at it too long. Ronnie was with me as well. He was also attracted by a very similar one, but it was dark blue, as in, you know, the colour cobalt? Cobalt?
Cobalt
blue, is that how you say it? Which is like a dark, like a nighttime sky blue.
Right, yeah.
Similar, with the little sparkly bits in it. And we just stood there for too long when we heard those words. Can I help you?
Can we help you, sir?
Can I help you, sir? No, I was really rude. I don't know what came over me. I said, no. No. Oh, she said, and laughed and walked off. And then I felt really bad about that. I don't know why I spoke to her like that. That was completely uncalled for and unnecessary. Anyway, so I said, I'm just looking at this. Is beautiful, this red. She said, yes. I said, what do you do? Take the whole worktop? She said, no. What they do is put it on top of what you've already got. Did you know this?
Yep.
You probably know this already. My kitchen, I've got like a long bit along one side with the sink and all that in it. So that'd be one worktop. Of course, you'd have to cut out a bit in the middle. I don't know how they do that. And I've also got another bit in the middle. Now, there's a name for that. I can't think what it is.
Island bar.
Is it an island? Is that what it's called?
An island bar.
Okay, so that comes out and it's like curved and comes back on the wall. And what they would do, apparently, is measure it up and bring it and fit it on top of that. And I'm very, very... not cheap. Oh, my God. No. Not cheap at all, dear. Not cheap. But I can't lie to you. I am a bit tempted by that.
Did your credit card start trembling in your pocket?
Something was definitely vibrating in my pocket. It might have been my... It was frightened that it was going to be used. And especially the day... You know, especially, I still had this idea of a jacket in my head as well. But I didn't buy that. You know, I haven't bought the jacket.
No, that's right.
I haven't bought the jacket. But as I say, you know, I keep saying I've got a little plan in my head. And this time next year, I want to be at that point. And if I start doing things like that, then I'm not going to get there. So
then you're not going
to
get there.
Stick to the plan, dear. But it's...
think of your plan and the inevitable words of Miss Jason. Set yourself a goal. Believe it in your soul. And one day you will cross that stream if you hold on to your dream.
What is this, bloody poetry hour or something?
No.
Not poetry. Poetry. I can't stand poetry.
Quoting some words from a famous songster, Miss Jason.
We should have her in here to sing that live, I think. We'll have to do a live show with Miss Jason. Let me just tell you, boys and girls, Miss Jason is a very, very popular drag queen in London. She's old school. She's old school. So she looks like a proper woman, not a bloke in a dress. And it's just not right, that isn't, you know. It's there's no beards or anything like that. She look, you know, got the wig and all that business. And she's really, really good. And she's a lovely person as well. She's such a nice person.
Yeah. I can vouch for that. I've spent many an evening with Jason.
Have you really? Did she pay you?
on the Isle of Widget.
On the Isle of Widget. Oh, we have millions of viewers on the Isle of Wight, you know. Millions. Millions.
Yes, We holidayed together on the Isle of Widget for a show that we were doing.
Oh, I didn't
know
that. Oh, okay. So what do you reckon on this red granite? Oh, it's beautiful, this granite top. Is that something you've fitted before?
No, don't do granite worktops. That's a specialist field for granite worktops. They normally have to be measured and cut by the granite people because it's all specialist tools, and they bring it along and do it. They sometimes do it on site, or sometimes they sort of measure
up and
bring the bits to site.
If they were, if something like that was fitted, do they scratch? You know, like sometimes you cut an onion up on the chopping board and the chopping board ends up scratched to pieces. Would the same still happen with the granite top?
I think over a period of time you may get a slight bit of wear, but then I believe you can have them sort of repolished.
Right, right.
But obviously, you know, it depends on your grand plan. You know, I mean, would it really be worth replacing the worktop and keeping the existing units? Are they in a good condition? Because you've had those repaired a couple of times over the years, haven't you?
Where
they've dropped off the wall and stuff.
One came off the wall. But that was fixed, and it still seemed to... I think, I mean, there's a lot of plates and cups in there. Perhaps those ones at the top are not really... You're supposed to put plates and cups in there.
Yeah.
I mean, even when I pick up... You know, you pick up 10 plates, that's a lot of weight. Well, there's a hell of a lot more than 10 plates in that cupboard. Maybe you should put those on...
Well, it's been up there a while now. I mean, it's been up there since about the... let me think. Roughly around about the 11th of October 2011, I think that show was, when you mentioned about that cupboard.
God, haven't you got a good memory? Memory.
I am the aficionado of the Chris Reardon United Kingdom Talk Historian Television International Show, you know.
Memories like the corners of my mind. Talking of memories.
It's either that or I'm as sad as you.
Talking of memories, when I come out of the garden centre, meanwhile, we fancied an ice cream. There's an Italian ice cream. He's a bit dear. We're talking £3.50 for a tub of Mr. Whippy ice cream. Anyway, so I approached him. And, of course, he closes for the winter. He's not there the whole winter. He closes round about September. And so he can only have been open a couple of weeks. Anyway, I went up to him. Oh, how are you? Medium Mr. Whippy. And I'm like, how did you remember that? I said, that was over 6 months ago. He says, I remember good customers. So, you know, I obviously bought quite a few. And he knew me straight away. That's excellent customer service.
That certainly is.
Just like I received from Tom Tom, the lady in India or Pakistan, whichever it was. Tom Tom, excellent customer service the other day. Thank you. Sorry?
Yes, indeed. Now, the other thing I'm ringing in about, Chris, is you mentioned earlier I was building my website.
Yes.
I need help. I need a viewer or viewers to. I need to either go to somebody's house or somebody's come to me, and I need them to help me build the website because I have no idea what I'm doing. I sat there all last night trying to work it out, and in the end, I just shut the computer down and went to bed.
Yes. What did you use?
Well, I've used a site called WordPress.
Word what?
WordPress.
Oh, I've heard of that.
Yeah, WordPress.
Okay, create a site. See, I don't know. WordPress gets started. What's that do? Comes up. Hello, let's create your new site. Start a website. Start with a blog or start with a website?
It'd be a website, but I've paid for one. You see, I've paid a £30 charge to get the slightly better site and the personal one. Takes all the adverts away from it, and you can also have your domain name on it as well.
Did you choose a theme?
Not as yet, no. I'm sort of early stage. I was just trying to get the domain name to work, which I can't seem to get to work for some reason. If you type it in, it doesn't seem to work at the moment, which is adamtheplumber.co.uk. And it doesn't seem to recognise that that domain name is there.
Maybe I've got to
activate it somehow.
Who are you with?
I bought it off of Google. It was from Google.
Google?
I typed into Google domain names, and up came the domain names from Google.
Domain names, okay.
And paid £10 for the year to have the domain name for the year. So I paid £10 for the domain name for the year.
Right.
And when you check back on it, if you check on Google search for domain names, it is actually now occupied. So I must have bought it, and I've got the bill to prove that I've paid for it. But I just can't seem to get it to activate. I don't know what I've got to do.
I'm looking at it, and I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So I'm just wondering if there's a viewer out there in London that could possibly help me, and I'll buy them dinner or something if they take them out to dinner or something.
There you
go. They can help me build the site.
So they know who you are. You're Adam. Adam. What's your son? Adam Tubro. And you'll see he's put messages, or you can find him on my friends. What do you call it? That friends list on Facebook. Adam is on there. So if you can help him in any way with that one, then please do. Because I can't. I don't. I mean, I've used UK2 thing. I think I've used.
UK Genet 2, yeah, or something. Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't know. It's a different one. You see, it's a different one.
Mm. I mean, I've used.
Look at this, Wayne. Go on. What'd you say?
I've been using WordPress for quite a long time for the church's website.
Right.
I run. I've been using WordPress, and that's no problem. But the new, now I've downloaded this one, they've completely and utterly changed it it works.
That's the thing, and you see. They blooming change things.
How it works.
They can't leave things alone. They have to change them, and then we don't know what we're doing anymore.
Yeah, exactly. I've got an old version of WordPress on the church's website, and it works fine. I know what to do. I know how to create pages.
Yeah.
This is similar, but everything, it's different. So I don't know what to think of it. And, of course, the problem is I've paid for it now for a year, so I need to use it.
Yeah. Oh, you want to learn how it's done, don't you?
Mm-mm. Yeah. I mean, I'll be all right. Once I got the adamtheplumber.co.uk.
Yes.
And I've got the first page sort of running, and it's a live running website.
But you don't know how to do it.
I'll be fine.
Well, hopefully someone will ring you and let you know, we'll send you a message and I'll be able to assist you.
Yes, indeed.
In your inquiry.
Okay, thank you very much.
Have a lovely afternoon, Adam.
Thank you. I think Wayne Martin's put a message up there, hasn't he?
Yes, I'm just going to read those in a minute.
Yep, okay, no worries. Thanks,
Take
Chris.
Care now. Au revoir.
Bye-bye.
Adam the plumber is in the house again. Oh, he's the only one that ever rings up regularly. He really is. Good morning to Keith Georgie with us. Wayne says, granite is a very hard wearing, Chris. And my mum has had it and it doesn't mark if it's real granite. Oh, it was beautiful. It was beautiful, this red granite stuff. Good morning to Sky, who's in Disneyland at the moment. Good morning, Sky. Which Disney are you? Are you at the proper Disney in Florida, or are you at that nasty little French one? Which overcharge you left, right and centre. God's sake. Jerry Green's with us this morning. Good morning, Jerry. Wayne says he loves Long Acres Garden Centre. Yeah, it's a bit big. There's a lot of stuff in there that seems to be a bit unnecessary to me. But yeah, it's very expensive in there as well. There is another garden centre, Ashridge in Wokingham. Now, I don't know if you know that one. It's much smaller. And generally, they've only got plants in the garden centre themselves. Although they have... Oh, do you know, there's something itching. Oh, you know what's happened? Oh, there it is. Hang on. 1 minute. I think there's... Where I was cutting the grass this morning, I was doing some other stuff out there. And I think there's a rose thorn or something like that embedded in my trouser that keeps scratching my blooming leg. Not a rose thorn, from brambles, you know, that sort of thing. Yeah. Wokingham, that is. Ashridge Garden Centre. Try that one. It's much, much cheaper there, OK? Hello to Ashley Smith. Chris and his counterfeit garden vouchers. That'd be what it is. Counterfeit garden vouchers. If you want anything printed at all, Ashley, just let me know. You know, banknotes. Can't do the new fivers, I'm afraid. Can't do the new fivers. But if you want one of the old tenors, a 20, just let me know. I'll print a couple off for you. No problem at all. Elaine loves the lamp. Thank you, Elaine. That's our little United Kingdom. That was very cheap, that was. No, hang on. Someone bought me this. I think my sister bought me that. No, I didn't buy that. My sister bought me that. It's nice, isn't it? Very colourful. Shall we turn it round a bit? Let's get the Union Jack up there a bit better. And that there, Eloise bought me that about a year ago and sent it in the post. Isn't that kind? People send things in. Johnny Key's got to go because his battery has died. Sorry about that, Johnny. What are you going to do when we get robots? Halfway through the job, or a job, the robot's battery dies. That will leave us in a mess, won't it? good. And Keith George is with us as well this morning. I did try and ring you earlier, Keith, but I couldn't get hold of you. Hang on a second. Let's just renew this. Stephen says, have you got fleas? Quite possibly, Stephen. Oh, don't. I've had those in the house before. Oh, it makes you feel disgustingly dirty. That's when the cats, I had three cats and they were all in and out of the house all the time. And I never forget sitting there on the chair and I, what was that? You know, just brushed me, nothing on there. And basically I'd got fleas in the house and it was terrible. And I had to go to the, I tried the supermarket stuff, which was completely useless. And I went down to the vets and I said, oh, it's very, in a quiet voice, you know, because I don't want other people hearing it. I think I've got fleas in the house. She said, oh, okay, you need some of this. And she got me this great big can of spray stuff. She said, there you go, use that. That'll get rid of them all straight away. I said, all right, then. I said, is one enough? She said, what, you've got three bedroom house? She said, well, you need two. The only thing is they're £16 each. That's fine. That's fine. Just give me the cans. I think I bought three in the end. And you bring them back to the house. I read the instructions. So what I had to do was spray all round the edges, OK? And then you spray this stuff up in the air while holding something over your mouth like that, you know. You know, don't want to poison myself, do you? Spraying this stuff in the air. And then you close the doors and you have to leave it, I think, for 6 hours. So you leave that. So I did it before I went to work. Done all this in the house. So I went to work, come back again. I open the door, you know, carefully. I didn't want to gas myself like that. I am like that. And as I went in the living room, well, it was carnage. All these dead things were on the floor. I couldn't believe it. Flies, spiders, all sorts of stuff. I thought, where has this all come from? Well, it must have been living with me, dear. I'm running a free zoo for insects. And anyway, so I did all that and they never came back again. I never ever saw or felt a single flea in here after that. So it was bloody good stuff. Well worth the 32 quid or whatever it cost me. Well worth it. You have to have special spray. Don't get the stuff in the supermarket. It's useless. I tried the stuff in the supermarket and it didn't do anything. It didn't do anything at all. You put this powder down for 2 days, no fleas, and then they come back again. Oh, it makes you feel so dirty. They're tiny little brown things and they jump up onto your leg and bite you. Evil. Evil. Ashley said three cans at £16 each. Chris has more money than says. But it got rid of the fleas, Ashley. Well, but I bet your place is filthy, isn't it, Ashley? I bet your place is disgusting. You won't spend any money on cleaning materials or anything, will you? God's sake, I wouldn't like to come to your place. I bet it's alive in there, alive. Oh, dear. Looks like Wayne's going to the gym. Have you just started, Wayne, looking at your photo? You haven't been going long, have you, love? Want to get down there a little bit more often, mate? Let's do some stories for you this morning. I've told you about today. Let me just cross that off now. Don't want to repeat myself. Don't want to be like ITV. Some stories for you this morning, boys and girls. Ministers, this now, what do you think of this? Ministers have given the green light for Formula One in London. Yeah, believe this. Look at this. Ministers have given the green light for a British Grand Prix on the streets of London to promote Brexit Britain around the world. A change in the law means that from Monday, motorsports will be allowed to take place on public roads across England for the first time. Oh, my God. You can't make this up, can you? In London. Can you just imagine the traffic chaos that is going to cause? What a stupid idea. What an absolutely stupid idea. The move has delighted campaigners. I bet it has. The move has delighted campaigners who have led. What's going on here? Is someone trying to call in? I keep getting a website blocked message up here. I don't know what that is. If you're trying to call in, could you just put a message on the Facebook? There might be something wrong with the Skype. I don't know. No, actually, Adam called it. If you're trying to call in, just put a little message on the Facebook and let me know. Anyway, the move has delighted campaigners who have led a 7-year battle for a seismic shift in this. And it paved the way for a £100 million F1 bonanza for the British economy within a year. Last night, Transport Minister Andrew Jones... I wonder if he's from Wales. Everyone from Wales is called Jones. Have you noticed that, lovey? Have you noticed that? Last night, Transport Manager Andrew Jones declared a fair F1 race with the backdrop of London would be spectacular and a great advert for post-Brexit Britain. I'm sure it would look lovely. I'm sure it would look lovely. But that, can you just imagine the traffic? Where's it all supposed to go? He added the government has done its bit by creating the legislation to enable this to happen. Former world championship Nigel Mansell held the great move forward for the sport and will bring visitors and pride to Britain. So I don't know what you think about that, boys and girls. The route looks like it goes past the Houses of Parliament and Buckingham Palace. I mean, I'm sure it'll look fantastic. I'm sure it will. But I'm just thinking the amount of traffic and all that, that's going to upset as it comes round. I shan't work that night, I don't think. I think I won't give up that night. I'll give that night to someone else. They can deal with the traffic. I think we've only got time for the one story today. It's 10 past 12 already. Look at that. Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Oh, I didn't get around to... Wendy sent some stuff in, which is really excellent. I'll have to do that another day, Wendy. Sorry, darling. We didn't get to that, do we? Let's just save that to my stories section. Oh, I wanted to do that one today. Maybe we'll do that at some point tomorrow because we've got a bit more time tomorrow. I'm off tomorrow. Let's do today's birthdays and then we'll disappear, gang. Happy birthday today to the lovely Alex. Alex Burrows, it's his birthday today. 38 years old today. One of London's most popular bus drivers. Ding, ding. Mind the door. Oh, no, that's the underground train, isn't it? He pushes that little button and those doors close like that. Oh, I love it. Happy birthday, Alex. Very nice person he is. 38 years old today. Happy birthday today to Marshall Mahendran. Happy birthday to you, Marshall. Hope I got that right. Duncan Aaron Day. I haven't seen you for ages. 33 years old today. Happy birthday to Duncan. Barry Dillaway, who works actually at the estate agent that looks after my properties. It's his birthday today. Happy birthday, Barry. Craig Wright. Now, are you in Wales, Craig? Are you the Craig in Wales? Oh, let me get that right. Just a moment, please, Craig. I shall know. I think it is you, isn't it? Is it you in Wales? Oh, no, maybe not. Yes, that's you, isn't it? God, it's like, haven't you grown up? Blimey. It is you. Are you in Wrexham? No, Mountain Ash. I remember you, Craig. My God, I haven't seen you for ages and ages and ages. Craig, I've never met Craig in person, but he's one of my Facebook friends. So happy birthday to Craig. Absolute pleasure to see your little face on there. What, are you 28 today? Where's all that gone, eh? I've known him for about 10 years. Leigh Brown today is 31 years old today. Happy birthday, Leigh. When are you coming to sing for me again? I haven't heard you sing for ages. Happy birthday, Leigh. And Sam Quereshi. Sam Quereshi is 54 years today. So there the birthdays. Shall we sing? And I've got the button pushed today so you can hear the music. Look at this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Have a wonderful birthday, whatever you're doing. I'm sure some of you are going out tonight, all right? All right. Finally, Stephen sends a picture here of a robot laying bricks. Oh, yes. Robots are now able to lay house bricks in 2 days. You see, no jobs are safe, are they? No jobs are safe. I think, in particular, the jobs that will disappear, I think, in vast numbers will be... driving jobs. I really think they're going to disappear first because it's coming very quickly now, isn't it? The whole I've cut that too quick there, haven't I? Anyway, just a moment. I've forgotten what I'm doing now. One second, I've done something wrong. Oh, where's that gone? I've been trying to be clever with this today. I think close. Where's that close? There it is. 1 minute, let's get that ready there. Yeah, I think driving jobs will go first.
lorries, buses, trains. I mean, in America, they're subway. There's no drivers on those trains on the subway. Did you know that? You know, if they can do it here, they can do it. If they can do it there, they can do it here. It's only the unions holding a lot of this stuff up that they want to hold on to their jobs and things like that. But I think driving jobs will disappear in vast numbers shortly. Lorries and buses in particular. So I don't think any jobs are safe. Except, of course, this one. I mean, who else could do what I do? Be honest with you. Anyway, that's it for the show today. Thank you very much, boys and girls. I'm doing a little bit of DJing tonight at Central Station. Nice short night for me, 9:30 till midnight with Cabaret on at 10:30. I actually don't know what the Cabaret is tonight. But if you come down, I'm sure it'll be rather wonderful. Apart from that, enjoy your Saturday and I'll see you again very soon. Thank you very much for joining me. Cheerio now.